Today, I'm going to show you how to create time-lapse movies using Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018. This is for those of you that have chosen to use the manual method of creating a time-lapse movie. That's by creating a sequence of still images and doing the editing yourself. If you've picked up a newer SLR camera, quite often they have an automated time-lapse mode. Even your iPhone does this automatically for you. I'm using my old 5D Mark III camera, which is still a great camera. It doesn't have time-lapse mode in there. So I've got an external device here called an intervalometer, and that allows me to set my increments between shooting. I can choose 1 second intervals, for example, 3, 5, 10. And again, if you've got a newer camera, you don't have to worry about it because there will be time-lapse settings in the camera itself. And you can choose for the camera to create a movie for you. And quite often you can go into manual mode so that it creates these image stills that I was referring to. Now, before I go into Premiere, the first thing I like to do is to take all my photos into Adobe Lightroom and perform a basic edit to improve the overall look. So obviously, once you open up Lightroom, the first thing you need to do is import all of your images. Once you do that, select any one of the images, probably the first one that appears in the thumbnail view, and go ahead, enter develop mode, and perform all of your edits. The image that I've selected here looks really quite dull and flat, so I'm going to increase the contrast, the saturation, and adjust various parameters just to make the image punch much more. And if you take a look at the side-by-side comparison, you can see the major improvement on the image to the right, which is the final edited image. So we're pretty much ready to sync that edit across to all the other images. So all you need to do is select the Shift key and select all of the images you want those filters applied to, and then hit the sync button. Once you've done that, a pop-up box will appear asking you which of the settings that you've just changed you'd like to sync across. Once you hit the sync button, just allow a couple of moments for the information to apply. Then you can go ahead and export all your photos into a folder ready for import into Premiere. Now we're going to go ahead and import the image sequence. Now to do this, I'm going to navigate to my folder, and I'll do that by going to File, Import, and select the first file that appears in my folder. So I'm not going to select all the images, just the first file. Now before I press import, you'll notice there is a button on the left-hand side of the pop-up window called Options. If you select this, a sub-menu item appears, and there is now an option to import an image sequence. Make sure that you've selected the tick in this checkbox, and that will ensure that Premiere Pro will import not only the first photo, but all of the subsequent images in that folder as a time-lapse movie. So let's go ahead and select import. And if you have a look at your project window on the left-hand side, the image sequence that you imported appears as a movie clip, and you can now drag this onto the timeline. And if you scrub the timeline backwards and forwards, you'll see that it is in fact a time-lapse movie. And if necessary, we can go and change some parameters of this image sequence video clip. We can change the scale, which is usually necessary. And if you like, you can even change the speed and duration of your clip, make it go slower or faster, depending on the look that you're trying to achieve. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you know what to do. Hit me up with a like and consider subscribing to the channel, and you'll be notified of up and coming video releases. If you felt that I've left anything out, don't hesitate to put your comments in the comments box below, and I'll see if I can get back to you as soon as I can with an answer. Thanks again. See you in the next video. Bye for now.